Don Brash is for the second time in a week at the centre of what free speech means in New Zealand. Following widespread outrage after his speech at Massey University was cancelled on Tuesday, he's now going to have to face protesters at a debate at Auckland University tonight. The student-run debate, due to start in the next few minutes, asks, has PC culture gone too far to the point of limiting freedom of speech? About 20 protesters have gathered in the past half hour to protest, vowing to disrupt Mr. Brash's speech. The debating society says he offers valuable insight, while some students say his views on Māori have no place at a university. Zach Fleming has more.
It's anti-hate speech versus pro-free speech.
It's not because of the debate or any of the other speakers, it's because of Don Brash and his racist views.
This is a debate about freedom of speech, not about his involvement in Hobson's pledge or anything like that.
Chris Ryan, the president of Auckland University's debating society, says Don Brash was locked in for the society's freedom of speech debate months ago, to no fanfare.
And then in the course of organising the debate, it's just kind of picked up steam, and now we're here.
Any regrets now that we're here?
No regrets.
Where we are is a national debate about free speech, after Massey University on Tuesday cancelled a talk from Don Brash, citing security concerns. That move drew widespread scorn, including from the Prime Minister, and now no fanfare has turned into guaranteed protests outside tonight's debate. Kartusia Balsink will be there with a new university.
His racist views on the Titiriti, Waitangi and kind of the place of Māori culture within modern-day Aotearoa. We reject that those racist viewpoints have a place on a modern-day university campus.
I think the process of a debate means that to the extent that Don might present ideas that are wrong, they'll be debunked just by virtue of the process of a debate. But I also think it's unlikely that he is going to raise any issues that are problematic. He's spoken extensively in the media about freedom of speech, and this is a debate about freedom of speech.
Overnight, the number of people attending the debate more than doubled, forcing the debating society to switch to a much bigger venue. And if the US is anything to go by, this issue of free speech on campuses is only going to get more divisive.
Do you reckon Don Brash should be able to speak at the university?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, he definitely should. Everyone should have the right to freedom of speech, and if you don't like it, you have the right not to come.
Oh, I'm not going to get into that can of worms, mate.
It's good to get people who don't have the same opinion of you speaking in public places, because that raises, you know, conversation about the opposing opinion, if that makes sense.
You should be allowed to voice your opinions.
Regardless of what those opinions are.
Of course, that's the whole point of a democracy, isn't it?
I don't see it as particularly controversial. I understand that it has raised a controversy over there, but I think...
That's Sigal Ben Parath, a professor at the University of Pennsylvania, who wrote a book titled Free Speech on Campus. She was talking about Don Brash being uninvited from Massey University and says we're making a mountain out of a molehill.
Your higher education sector is quite open and allows for a lot of debate about controversial and other topics, and one event being cancelled or postponed is definitely not a great cause of concern.
But the Free Speech Coalition, which Don Brash is a part of, disagrees. They're threatening legal action against Massey University for cancelling Don Brash's speech.
It seems like the using health and safety as an excuse to shut down views that the people in power don't like.
But legal action is unlikely to be a problem here at Auckland University. The debating society won't be cancelling the event because the protests held here in the courtyard just outside are expected to be peaceful. Around 600 people are expected to attend tonight. For Checkpoint, Zach Fleming.